Welcome back, lawn lovers. BW here. Hey, let's test out another sprinkler. I had so much fun testing my last new sprinkler, the Rain Bird 6504 Falcon, that I decided to buy and test its main competitor, the Hunter I40. I selected and installed the proper nozzle so that they would have almost identical specifications as far as flow and spray distance are concerned. Both of these sprinklers were made to water very large areas and are even used on athletic fields. Comparing these two sprinklers may be a lot like comparing Ford to Chevy. People seem to prefer one over the other, even when the differences between the two may not be very significant. I've read that their spray patterns are a little bit different, and that's what I'm most interested in today. I have almost identical weather conditions today as I had when I tested the Rain Bird, a 3 mph breeze from behind the sprinkler. Once again, I stepped off my measuring cups at 3 paces, or about 9 feet each, for a total distance of 36 feet. This time I placed an additional measuring cup just 1 step from the sprinkler. I have these measuring cups that I bought online somewhere a few years ago. You can look for something like this online, or use any type of container that has vertical sides like a tuna can, and then measure the water with a ruler. You can also use a couple of rain gauges if you have them. I have a soil moisture sensor for my weather station buried 4 inches deep, just 6 feet to the left of the white sending unit that you can see in the old sandbox. Just a little farther from the sprinkler than the first measuring cup. I found from experience that it takes about 1/2 inch of water for it to register an increase in the soil moisture, and it took the Rain Bird about 1 hour and 20 minutes to deliver that amount of water. This Hunter sprinkler is spraying about the same distance as the Rain Bird, but this watering only took 1 hour and 5 minutes to register an increase in the soil moisture. 15 minutes less than the Rain Bird. Can it really be putting out that much more water than the Rain Bird? Let's take a look at the measuring cups. Starting with cup number 4, I see that it contains exactly 1/4 inch of water. Cup number 3 contains just under 1/4 inch of water. Cup number 2 contains just over 1/4 inch of water. And cup number 1 contains more than 1/2 inch of water. Cup 1 step from the sprinkler contains less than 1/4 inch of water. For comparison, I went out off camera on another occasion and placed the cup 1 step from the Rain Bird sprinkler and recorded 3/4 inch of water. Well, that's interesting. The Hunter has a relatively even spray pattern except for a significant bulge at the first cup, so it's putting water there faster than it can water the rest of the spray pattern, and triggers the moisture sensor in a shorter amount of time. I was really surprised by this. All my other rotary sprinklers, even the impact sprinklers, all seem to have a spray distribution more like the Rain Bird. The Rain Bird had a smoother distribution curve with more water at the sprinkler and less at the end of the spray pattern. That allows me to reduce the number of times I need to move the sprinkler by overlapping my spray only halfway while still getting an even distribution of water. Overlapping the Hunter head-to-head should still work pretty well for an in-ground system, but won't work very well for me using it portably and overlapping only halfway. I'll be getting some big dry areas and a small dry area right next to the sprinkler. The Rain Bird puts down a little extra water right next to the sprinkler, but that's okay in such a small area, and it's better than a dry spot. I think it's fair to say that the Rain Bird is the winner for someone like me, using it in a portable manner, and I think most would say that the Rain Bird spray pattern is better in most situations. I can adjust the Hunter to water a full circle, but Rain Bird offers a full circle model as well. The Rain Bird can be adjusted with any small screwdriver, while the Hunter needs a special tool. Most sprinklers need a 3/4 inch professional contractor grade garden hose and good water pressure to power a sprinkler this big. There may be differences in durability, reliability, and repairability, but I've only owned these sprinklers for a very short time and haven't experienced any problems so far. This test surprised me. I think I'll be using the Rain Bird for most of my watering, but I'm sure I can find places to use the Hunter as well. Don't forget to subscribe, and remember, you can do it!